Hello and welcome back. Today I'm having some problems with my Arturia Beatstep Pro. Let me show you what it's doing. That's no good. There we go. Let's see what's got to be done. This is the USB connection here. I want to replace that with this one. This came out of a Korg Slim controllers. If this goes south, I still can hardwire, you know, this wire to these connections that are in here. I'm having to break out the big guns on these soldering pins. They just won't come loose with this braid stuff. Let's see what happens. I'm having to heat up the sides of the housing and then pulling up at the same time. There we go. I think it's coming out. All right, now what I want to do is I need to file this opening down just a little bit bigger, just so that this thing can slip through there. Let's get real. These little ground tabs break off quite easily, so that's just what I'll do. Okay, what you want to be able to do is be able to place it, have it pass through, have it come all the way through and out the other side. Okay, to mount the new USB jack, first I'm gonna install some bus wire down into these the ground pins, and you'll see why I do that here in a minute. And then cut it to a longer length than I really need, but you'll see, it'll make sense. Then I wrap the bus wire around it so it holds it in place while I do this delicate, tiny-ass soldering here. Let's see what happens. Hope this doesn't go to hell, too. All this thing really wants to do is do a solder bridge across all the frickin' terminals. So, traces have bridged themselves again. Let me show you what's going on here. Here's my new USB connector, and here are the tracks, and these are the connections that were to be made with the solder. But what happened is up inside here, the bridging ran away from me into an area where I couldn't get to it. I'd have to tear this off again, which is what I did, and these traces just got torn apart when I was doing that. And I even ruined my connector. It pulled some of the leads out of the USB connector. Fun. But what I ended up doing is hardwiring this thing based on a YouTube video that I saw. I'm putting up the link now so that you can look at it. This restored functionality back to my Beatstep Pro. His video is very good if that's something you want to attempt, and I would recommend it because I'm no good at surface mount technology. One thing I would recommend is that you go ahead and get a hot glue gun and fill in this area here so that it will relieve some of the strain. So let's test it and make sure everything's working. Now it's time to test it out. What better than to do some acid music, some acid house. Let's have it. Nope. looks like it's working just fine. Well, this is what I did with mine, and I can say that it works just fine, and for now, and I'll be getting a lot of use out of it once again, and thank you for watching.